Hello friends, welcome again. And this is my new project, Human Resource Management System. And I have developed this project in Python, Django and MySQL. The version for the Python I'm using is the Python version 3, and the Django version is 2. And the database I'm using is the MySQL, and the version for the MySQL I'm using is the MySQL 5.6. For connecting the MySQL with Python, I'm using the MySQL Python connector, which you will get easily from the mysql.org website. Also, you can install the MySQL and the Python connector using the pip command, right? For front-end development, I'm using the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Also, some of the jQuery library also I have used, like calendar integration, creating the drop-down menus, integration of the form validations. I have used the jQuery plugins. All of the client-side validation has been done by the JavaScript, right? So let's start with the functionality go through. So the project title is Human Resource Management System. It's a web-based Python Django MySQL project. Okay, and it's a mini project which contains only and only admin login. There is no login provision for the employee and the other users. It's a mini project, that's why it contains only and only single user role login, that is the admin. Okay, so let's start with the functionality go through. So this is the home page of the project. You can see this is a simple source home page. If you want to change the content, you can change the content from the base.html. And this is the about from where this is about of the project. If you want to change it, then you can change from the file directly. This is a contact us. It's a static page also. I am not sending any type of email and SMS from this system, right? Also, I am not saving the details of this contact us anywhere into database. So you can treat it as a static page. This is a login page from where admin will be able to log in and he can perform the certain operations, right? So let's log inside the system. The user ID is admin and the password test. This is the admin dashboard, right? So these operation admin can perform, means admin can add the employee, admin can see the employee details, admin can add the salary, admin can see the salary details. Also, admin can change his account password and the logout functionality, right? So let me go through one by one. So this is the employee management, add employee. So from here, admin will be able to enter all of the details of the employee, and he can save the details into the MySQL database, right? All the details we are saving into the MySQL database, right? So these are the fields of the employee, and admin can save these all details into the database, right? This is the employee details. Once admin clicks on the employee details, all of the employees which has been added into the database will be displayed here, right? Also, if admin wants to edit or delete the records, admin can do it from here, right? So admin can edit the records from here. Also, if he want to delete, then he can delete from here, right? Okay, so this is the wait. Okay, so this is the add salary part, from where admin will be able to save the salary of the employee, right? So admin will be able to see the details, see all of the employees which have been added, and he can select the employee and save the salary, right? These all are the part of the salary, and admin will enter all of the details, and after that he can save the details, right? These are salary details. All of the salary which has been added by admin will be displayed here, right? Once you click on the edit, you will be able to see all of the parts, okay? And even you can update the details. This is a change password, from where admin will be able to change his account password, and after that he will be able to log in with this updated password, right? This old password will not work, okay? This is the logout functionality. Once admin log out from the system, the above menu will not be displayed, means the above administration menu will not be displayed, and no one can access those pages, right? But if admin wants to log in again, then just he will enter the user ID and password, and after that he will be able to perform the certain admin operations, right? So these are all things I have implemented inside the project. But if you need more functionality, then just put it to the comment. I will incorporate those changes and I will make this project more better and better according to the requirements. Okay, and don't forget to subscribe our channel for getting the latest video updates on the latest project technologies. Thanks for watching the video. Thank you very much.